asked to write compositions based on Christmas, with the best one to be read here today. One of our students, Virginia O'Hanlon, hoped to do one entitled, Why I Believe in Santa Claus. Well, we don't have a composition to read you today because Virginia, in her search for truth, is responsible for a most remarkable editorial, which is featured in today's New York Sun. I want you all to see the headline on today's editorial page. I will now read you this editorial. Is there a Santa Claus? We take great pleasure in answering at once and thus prominently the communication below, expressing at the same time
our great gratification that its faithful author is numbered among the friends of the Sun. Dear editor, I'm 8 years old. Some of my little friends say there is no Santa Claus. Papa says if you see it in the Sun, it's so. Please tell me the truth. Is there a Santa Claus? Virginia, your little friends are wrong. They've been affected by the skepticism of a skeptical age. They do not believe except they see. They think that nothing can be that is not comprehensible by their little minds. Yes, Virginia. Yes, there is a Santa Claus. He exists as certainly as love and generosity and devotion exist. Alas, how dreary would be the world if there was no Santa Claus. It would be as dreary as if there were no Virginias. There would be no childlike faith then, no poetry, no romance to make tolerable this existence. The most real things in the world are those that neither children nor men can see. Only faith, fancy, poetry, love, romance can push aside that curtain and view and picture the supernal beauty and glory beyond. Is it all real? Ah, Virginia, in this world, in all this world, there is nothing else real and abiding. No Santa Claus.
Thank God he lives, and he lives forever. 1,000 years from now, Virginia, nay, 10 times 10,000 years from now, he will continue to make glad the heart of childhood.